Russ probably feels like you should be talking about 3 points, never mind not claiming anything. I mean, how disappointed is it to lose in that manner?
Yeah, it's been a really long and tough 72 hours, not much sleep with everything that's gone on. And then we should be 3-0 up after like 20 minutes, half an hour. The penalty's given, it's not a penalty. It's a really poor decision for someone so close to it. Fish doesn't touch him. We reacted brilliantly. The performance was so good in the first half. So good, but we should have been outside. Two massive chances. John Raddy makes two good saves. And we paid for that lack of clinical edge. And then you can see the poor goal on the counter-attack to make it 2-2. Birmingham made some changes to help them energy. And so we changed formation to alleviate that and thought it worked really well. And then we gave them that one moment. So at that point, we're still so in control and looked like we might go and score a third. And then react brilliantly to it, pounce and mistake, go 3-2 up. And then Lats has to come off. We have no sub breaks left, so that's my fault. We didn't envisage there being that happening, and we made subs to try and help the team and change, tweak things. And they brought on a big threat, so we put Harry on to have three big guys there, and Lats defending at the back post as well. So that's my fault in hindsight. And then when you're down 10 minutes, it's difficult, right? They're throwing everything at it, big physical threat. We should be able to see it out, but we're not, unfortunately.
You mentioned set pieces in the past. You know, well, firstly, I don't even know if it was a corner or not. I think there's a bit of deliberation of that. Relevant either way, maybe. But to score from a header, granted you're down to 10 men or 9.
Yeah, no, it can't happen. It shouldn't happen. It's happened too many times. We'll have to really look at it because, we'll have to change something. But ultimately, down to the players on the pitch to have the mentality that they have something to protect and fight. And we didn't do it.
And ultimately, it is just one game, but it's just been an energy sapping week for all of you. You mentioned lack of sleep and everything that's gone on in the transfer window with the owners. And just where does this leave you all as a club? Because you can see so much positive stuff today, and it feels like it's been undone in a very short spell.
We have a really tough 15, 20 minutes today because we go down to 10 men, the energy. It feels much worse because everything that's gone on over the last few days. We've just been here too many times. Like, we can't concede 4 goals today. Not the way we played it for 60-odd minutes. And story of our season, really. They don't have a kick and then they get a penalty and score. They're not even close to our box at any point before that. We should, as I said, we should score and finish the game early on. It's that simple. So I don't really have the answers, Mitch, to be honest. I'll watch it back. I'll learn from the substitute thing, but it's been a difficult time, mate, so I don't really have much energy for giving you a really in-depth analysis, unfortunately.
Squad depth's obviously been an issue, hence why you were so determined to bolster your squad last month, which unfortunately just didn't happen from your point of view. But Joel Atterbury now going off, I mean, how is he, and is that another problem?
Yeah, he's got a calf strain, so hopefully it's not too serious, but he'll be out of next week, I would have thought. Not someone that's had an injury really since we've been here, so bit of a strange one. We'll have to have a look at everything we've done, but I've not done much in the last, yesterday and Thursday was really light to help them be ready for the same week as we always have, really. It's another blow for us, and one we'll have to try and deal with.
Was this the most kind of extreme example of the frustrations you've had this season? Because as you said, you could have been 5-1 up maybe at half time. You were so dominant, and then obviously goes against you with going down to 10 men, you can't make any more substitutions. Really frustrating afternoon.
Yeah.
Is this kind of the
encapsulate our season?
Absolutely.
One game. I think so. I've not felt as low as this, to be honest. I don't know. I don't know what to say to you. The performance was so good for 60 odd minutes. The crowd, the atmosphere was fantastic. respond to conceding a poor second goal. We got away with that action just before, where Chong was in a position where he was cheating a little bit and been asked to play a bit higher and take a gamble, and we tried to sort it there and then, and it happens again somehow and we get punished for it. Like the chances we create in the first half are such high quality, but the goals we concede just aren't, and we have to do something real high quality to penetrate the other team, and then we do that. So honestly, I cannot explain how we've conceded four goals. We'll watch it and analyse it. A bit lost for words, really.
I normally ask how do you pick the players up after a defeat of this manner? How are you going to pick yourself up, Russell? Because as you say, this is the most downbeat any of us have seen you, and it's, you know, you're a relentlessly positive guy and manager, and obviously you're hurting at the moment, but your first job is presumably to kind of pick yourself up.
Yeah, I think so. It's I've done my very best to keep everyone focused on what's important this week. Done my very best to be as honest as I possibly could with everyone, which probably made some people really unhappy. So I have to deal with that and the fallout from that. We had a real opportunity to sort of build on the togetherness and the support everyone's given each other this week, and we haven't quite taken it. So. Yeah, I'll be fine. It's difficult coming out and talking to you after a game when it's so much has happened. And as I said, lack of sleep doesn't help. Concern for so many people. And so it all takes energy away from you, right? But come Monday morning when the guys are back in, I'll be ready to go. And we'll continue with what we do, work hard, which is how the guys can go and perform like that for 60-odd, 65 minutes, where just totally dominant, and the game should be done. And we'll try and learn why the game's not done. And probably highlights the game in 90 minutes, as you said, like encapsulates the season, and highlights what we've probably lacked throughout.
You mentioned the fallout there. Have you spoken to the owners since your press conference?
Yeah, I don't want to get into that. Of course I have. It's not. Of course I have. So, yeah, we'll have to wait and see what happens.
Thank you. Thanks, Russ.
Thanks, Russ.